What's up, friends, and welcome back to my channel. So when I say sleep tracker, you might think ring, smartwatch, headband, or even mattress pad. But what if I said sticker? Okay, not quite a sticker, but these smart patches by the company Wesper, formerly known as Tatch, are an adhesive designed to be worn on your body while you sleep. So what makes this patch different from your traditional sleep wearable? How does it work and who is it designed for? And what could an innovation like this mean for the entire sleep industry? Well, stick around as I answer all of those questions and share with you the biggest lessons I learned about my own sleep habits from just one night of using the Wesper. So before we get into all of the specifics, I think we need to get the question of who is this thing actually for out of the way first, because I don't think it's necessarily for everyone. And let me explain. These patches are really designed for people who have concerns over very specific sleep issues like insomnia and sleep apnea, and they're interested in getting a full sleep diagnostic test done, but maybe don't want the hassle of having to go to a sleep lab. Now, that being said, these patches are not going to give you a medical diagnosis. However, they will give you some concrete insights around some key metrics, things like breathing, snoring, and overall restlessness. And so those insights might help steer you in the right direction towards addressing some of these sleep concerns. Now, I say all this not to dissuade anyone from buying these patches. And in fact, if you don't have a medical concern, but you're really just interested in optimizing your sleep routine, well, you might find the data that you get from these devices really useful. I certainly did. And I actually think that this type of technology is a great example of where the whole sleep industry is headed. But I'll get to that in a sec. But anyway, I just wanted to set some expectations with you guys so you know exactly upfront what you're getting and why the metrics that they measure matter. Getting all that out of the way, let's move on to the product itself. And let's start with the first question that I had when I first saw these things. How on earth do they work? And it's probably just easier to show you, so cue the B-roll. So when you open up the Wesper box, inside you'll find two crescent-shaped patches, along with some instructions on how to download their app. And a quick side note, right now this is only available for iPhone users. I know they're working on the whole Android thing, so stay tuned for that. When you flip the patches over to the sticky side, you'll see there's a very small microchip pulse oximeter built inside. But when you flip it over, you'll see the front part of the patch is made of this soft, plush fabric. And better yet, no wires. So you really shouldn't even have to think about this being on your body while you sleep. Then right before you get into bed, you'll open up the app and set up your patches. After you press the on button in the middle of the device, a green light will flash, connecting it to your phone. You'll then stick one of the patches right above your belly button, and the other one goes above the ribcage of your right chest. You'll also want to enable microphone access so that the app can pick up on any snoring sounds while you sleep. You'll then start the night, slip your way into bed, and then that's pretty much it. So as you can see, it's really a no-frills type of device, and honestly, the whole process took 5 minutes start to end. So now let's take a look at the actual sleep report and what kind of data you actually get the next day. So as you'll see here, there are really three major categories being measured: your sleep time, your breathing, and your snoring. But before we get to that, we have to take a second and look at this insane summary video from my night. So check this out. It's a full time lapse of your entire night. I have never seen a sleep report like this with such minute by minute precision around all my different sleeping positions. So guys, I swore for years that I was a side sleeper and a side sleeper only. But then again, do any of us know how much we're moving around when we're unconscious? So yeah, this report definitely shed some light for me on that front, but it also totally impressed the hell out of me. So, Oura Ring, step up your game, guys. Moving on to the raw data. And when you open up the sleep section, you'll see exactly how long you were asleep and how it actually compares to the national average. As you scroll down, you'll also see a breakdown of your total sleep efficiency, your latency, and the number of times you woke up based on your different sleeping positions in bed. When you open up the breathing section, you'll find a total breathing quality score at the top, which is basically based on the consistency of your breath patterns throughout the night. Now, as you can see, I got a score of fair, which, you know, it's not very type A of me. And that might be partly due to this weird dip that happened in my respiration graph, but the biggest factor for me probably has to do with my different sleeping positions. So as you'll see here, while on my back and my left side, it looks like my breathing quality wasn't as efficient as when I was sleeping on the right side, which is definitely something that surprised me a lot. And I'll talk more about that in just a sec. But the final section of this report really addresses snoring. Not really a problem I have, but when you open that up, you'll see your score at the top and then how that number compares to the national average. Now, what you don't get from this report that you might otherwise get from one of the sleep trackers like the Whoop or the Oura Ring are things like your REM and deep sleep scores, your HRV, and your temperature deviation. Now, I think those metrics are great and really useful in helping understand your sleep patterns over time. But as I mentioned at the beginning of this video, the WESPR is really a one-shot test designed to address specific sleep issues. So I'm okay having fewer metrics in this report, so long as I think their focus is on providing accuracy. The other thing that they do have going for them that you don't get from your standard tracker is a full sleep consultation. So after you take the test, you then have the option to book a one-on-one call with one of WESPR's in-house sleep specialists to go over your results. Since I was a bit concerned about that sleep quality score, I booked a call with Dr. Chelsea Rorscheib, who has a background in sleep genetics and neuroscience. Now, we talked at length about my entire sleep routine and all the possible things that could be affecting it. For me, she suggested using mouth tape at night, changing out my pillow, and trying to sleep more on the right side, since that tended to be the side with the best breathing quality score. Now, one of the biggest questions I had going into this one-night test was on accuracy. So I asked her, how can you really know if someone actually has a sleep issue if you're only getting a one-night snapshot?
If the person described to me that their sleep was consistently bad, then I would usually recommend multiple nights of testing. Now, with the breathing, on the other hand, we're taking samples all night throughout the night. And so that does allow us to capture a very good indication of whether you might have a breathing disorder. That would be the same as if you went to a hospital and had a sleep study done. One night is all they would need to do a diagnosis of something like sleep apnea.
So the big takeaway here is with this test, you probably only need one or two nights to really get a firm footing on your breathing quality. But for other things like insomnia and maybe even circadian rhythm disorder, you probably want to test for a longer period of time, maybe even a couple of weeks, so you have more data at your disposal and you can see if this is a pattern or just an outlier. And while we're on the subject of accuracy, let's take a look at how my WESPR data compared to both the Dream and my Oura Ring since I was crazy and wore all three devices on the same night. So as you can see from my data, there were some very close numbers between all three trackers for my total sleep time, heart rate, and efficiency. With latency though, not so much. But for me, what's most interesting is this drastic difference I saw in my sleeping positions between the WESPR and the Dream 2. And so as you'll see in this side-by-side video here, both devices were nearly spot on with my positions for the first half of the night. But around 2 a.m., things started to change. The Dream recorded me moving around a lot more than the WESPR did and showed the majority of the night spent side sleeping, whereas the WESPR recorded me sleeping on my back for more than half the night. Fascinating, right? Two devices, same night, totally different results. So which one is right? And it's really hard to say. On the one hand, the Dream 2 is an FDA registered device and has been around a lot longer than the WESPR, with nearly 7 years of research, 12 scientific publications, and over 2 million nights monitored. Now, the WESPR, on the other hand, is still a small startup. They just launched earlier this year, and in fact, I gave them user feedback for their beta version of the patch when they went under the name Tatch. Now, that being said, let's talk about placement, because the WESPR sensors are right on your stomach, whereas the Dream 2 sensors are on your head. So in theory, if my head moved throughout the night, but my body stayed still, would the Dream have picked that up as position changes? And so would that be accurate or not? Definitely something that requires additional testing, and I'll be sure to follow up with you guys when I've done some more side-by-side tests with both devices. But coming back to these patches, and let's talk about the pros and the cons before we dive into what this device might mean for the sleep industry. So on the plus side, these patches are actually really easy to apply, and they're pretty comfortable to wear all night. I was also surprised by just how well the patches stayed on. I have a pretty strained relationship with sticky adhesives, but these ones didn't fall off, no matter how many times I tossed and turned throughout the night. The fact that they're wireless and didn't require any charging beforehand was also a pretty big win for me. And then I've got to say, I really liked the layout and design of their sleep report. I mean, that video summary time-lapse alone is beyond, but the rest of the report is pretty aesthetic as well. It's well organized, it's clean, and it's so easy to interpret, I'm pretty sure my dog could read this report. And the final pro, which is incidentally also a con, is the whole one night thing. Now don't get me wrong, I love the idea of only having to wear something for one night. But then again, it would be really nice if these patches were reusable so you could test for multiple nights at a time. Instead, you have to ship your patches back every single time you use them, which isn't convenient and doesn't seem very scalable or cost effective to me. And speaking of cost, the service itself is kind of expensive. They're running on a membership plan right now, so the cost for a 90-day supply, unlimited, is gonna run you around $200. And for context, that is about $100 less than the Oura Ring. Now that being said, this product is designed to give you concrete insights in a short amount of time. So I really can't imagine that you would need to use this product for more than a couple of nights, maybe a month. And while it definitely doesn't replace the results you'd get from an actual sleep lab, it's definitely a lot less of a hassle. With a sleep lab, you have to deal with doctors and insurance, and you don't even sleep in your own bed. So if you're someone who is concerned about your sleep and you're thinking about a sleep lab, but not quite ready to pull that trigger, then I'd say Wesper might actually be a good place to start. Now, you won't get a medical diagnosis for sleep apnea or insomnia, but you will get some clarity and insights around what's actually going on, along with some actionable takeaways for what to do next. So my final thoughts on the Wesper are this. Do I think the device is perfect? Certainly not. None of them are. But I do think it has a lot of future potential. It's hard to believe, but if you think about it, sleep wearables weren't really a thing like a decade ago. I mean, it's really only in like the past 5 years that we started to see things shift, and you can probably thank the Oura Ring for a little bit of that. But really, the sleep tracking industry as a whole is still in its infancy. And so because much of the technology out there today is relying on algorithms, well, accuracy is still a big question when it comes to your data, which is why I always recommend that people still go and get a sleep lab if they have a medical issue they're concerned about with their sleep. Now, I still think that we are definitely a couple years out until we see lab level precision in some of these at-home wearables, but it's devices like the Wesper that are getting a little bit closer. I can see future iterations of this patch being rechargeable, so you get more data over longer stretches of time. And as nanotechnology emerges, we're gonna see even smaller devices with better accuracy start to emerge, especially on the EEG front, because form factor matters. And it is a big issue. You want to be comfortable while you're wearing something to sleep. And really the only way that we're going to solve some of the bigger sleep issues in this country is if we have the right tools that are accurate, affordable, comfortable, and easy to integrate into our everyday sleep routines. So that is my vision, and I might be wrong, but I am excited to be here right now in this space and watch this stuff all unfold with all of you guys. So that is it for today. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, if you learned something, maybe share it with a friend. And don't forget the subscribe, the bell, all the things. And until we meet again, I love you guys. But I gotta go to sleep now, so. Hey Google, lights out.